Now let's take a look at how some of the different safeguard strategies can be applied to detect hypothetical diversion. Remember that the full suite of IAEA safeguards measures will be used. These include nuclear material accountancy, containment and surveillance, design information verification, inspections, and reports. Outside the cascade halls, the safeguards activities are primarily based on material control and accountancy to deter or detect possible diversion. Inside the cascade halls, safeguards activities verify the proper use of the facility and in particular that no HEU is being produced. In addition, the state will be submitting periodic reports as mandated under the safeguards agreements. These reports shall include material inventory change reports, material balance reports, which shall include material unaccounted for and shipper receiver difference values, physical inventory listings, and declarations regarding the state's adherence to the additional protocol. When the IAEA conducts its inspections, be it periodic or unannounced, the inspectors will independently verify the accuracy and completeness of the periodic reports that are submitted by the state. During the inspection, the inspectors must be aware of various concealment strategies the facility operator might employ and be equipped to defeat these concealment attempts and correctly identify possible diversion or facility misuse in a timely manner. As a result, an inspector at a uranium enrichment facility will be looking to detect any signs of abrupt or protracted diversion. An abrupt diversion would be suspected if the calculated MUF value is greater than 1 SQ, as per verification goal 1. A protracted diversion would be suspected by statistical analysis of the MUF uncertainty, as per verification goals 2 and 3. With this in mind, let's take a look at how the inspector can detect possible diversion despite operator attempts to conceal the diversion attempt. To reiterate, the expected material unaccounted for, or MUF, in an item accounting MBA, for example, our cylinder storage area, is expected to be zero. Even in the storage area, occasionally the inspectors can verify the contents of randomly selected UF6 cylinders by performing enrichment and weight measurements. For the processing MBA, however, the expected MUF will be non-zero because bulk accounting is used. This is a concern for large facilities where the MUF and MUF uncertainty values correspond to large quantities of material. The inspector will independently verify that the MUF is less than 1 SQ to meet the first verification goal. The inspector then performs an analysis of MUF and MUF uncertainty, or sigma MUF. The inspector verifies the compliance regarding the second verification goal to ensure that the calculated MUF value is less than 3 sigma MUF. If these goals are met, the inspector also checks the third verification goal to ensure that 3 sigma MUF is less than 1 SQ. Note that these safeguards goals would have been checked and verified during the process to obtain an operating license for the facility and thus are expected to be maintained. The inspector will also perform statistical analysis of the reported MUF values to verify the accuracy of the reports that are being submitted to the IAEA by the state. This analysis includes analyzing trends within the reported MUF and MUF uncertainty values over several material balance periods, or MBPs, such as consistently high values for MUF uncertainty or an average MUF value that does not fluctuate around a predetermined average value. One statistical measure to detect diversion into MUF is the uranium MUF D statistic or the uranium 235 MUF D statistic. The MUF D statistics are extrapolated differences between the inspector and reported operator measurements that try to estimate the total amount by which the operator has falsified the MUF. It is basically an estimate of the true muff that takes into account the operator's influence. The inspector should be aware of any intentional equipment degradation that can cause misleading muff uncertainty. As part of normal inspections, the inspector would verify correct operation of the measurement equipment used for the physical inventory taking to determine if the quoted uncertainties in the muff value are indeed correct. If any degradation in the facility measurement equipment is detected, then immediate action to repair the equipment will be ordered. Thus, by ensuring that the three verification goals are met, that equipment performance is acceptable, and through statistical analysis on the reported muff and muff uncertainty values, the inspector will be able to detect protracted diversion of material by diversion into muff. If the inspector determines that any of these verifications are unsatisfactory, the state shall be required to provide explanations for the deficiencies. If the explanations are also unsatisfactory, the IAEA Director General shall report to the IAEA Board of Governors, which would call upon the state to remedy any non-compliance. Inspectors will also analyze book inventory records in order to verify that there has not been an artificial reduction in reported muff values. The analysis is performed to detect what we call defect items. A defect item is any item for which the reported values have been falsified. A gross defect in reporting involves a large falsification on a small number of items. A bias defect involves small falsifications over a large number of items. In addition, the inspector shall verify any inaccurate reporting of values for material purity and/or enrichment. Concealing a diversion by creating defect items is very difficult to achieve due to the in-depth analysis of records and the comprehensive sampling and testing of items employed by inspectors. The inspector will analyze and verify all records pertaining to the calculation of muff. The PB and PE records and documents maintained at the facility will include specifics regarding the quantity and type of material present at the beginning and end of the MBP. The R and S records and documents maintained at the facility will include specifics regarding the quantity and type of material received or shipped from the facility during the MBP. These records will also contain details about the distribution of material and any changes that affects the material within the facility. The inspector will verify the records for completeness and accuracy. Some things that the inspector will be looking for to verify for a uranium enrichment facility include the mass, volume, purity, and isotopic content of all feed, product, and waste materials. This should be done for all materials received, processed, stored, or shipped off-site, and for the material holdup within the MBA. The inspector will also take additional independent measurements to verify the state's declarations. Samples and measurements will be taken at all key measurement points, in addition to random sampling and testing of items such as feed, product, and waste UF6 containers. The inspector will again use statistical methods to confirm that all three verification goals are met. Thus, in-depth analyses of records and comprehensive sampling and testing of items will allow the inspector to detect diversion by biasing that employs falsifying records. Inspectors shall also verify records to detect a false report on loss of material. Loss of material can be genuine, for example, due to an accidental rupture of a cylinder or theft by outside actors. If such events are reported, the IAEA will use all available tools to verify the validity of the report, such as reviewing surveillance footage of the incident, checking the integrity of locks and seals, and inspecting operator records, In general, a material loss declaration would initiate an extensive and quite intrusive investigation of the facility and its operators, and could potentially result in a temporary or permanent shutdown of the facility. A final concern for safeguards inspectors at uranium enrichment facilities is not a diversion of material, but rather a misuse of the facilities to produce material enriched beyond the levels allowed or to enrich undeclared material. The inspector can detect facility misuse during a limited frequency unannounced access inspection. During these inspections, HEU production can be detected by taking swipe samples along the agreed access routes inside the cascade halls. Other indicators of HEU production are reduced throughput, portable feed and withdrawal equipment stations inside the cascade area, extra UF6 cylinders inside the cascade area, manipulation of valve settings, piping reconfiguration, and unusual changes in radiation signatures. Some of the above could also be used to indicate misuse of the facility. Under the additional protocol, wide area environmental sampling is conducted surrounding the enrichment facility to verify that the facility is operated per the declared plans of the state. In conclusion, misuse of the facility and diversion of uranium from the facility can be detected in a timely manner through the comprehensive nature of safeguards tools, strategies, and inspections that are carried out by the IAEA.